Hi, this is Marco Brigham, and welcome to the third tutorial of Deep Learning 2. Now that you know more about autoencoders and know how to build powerful models, let's put them to use in solving the MNIST cognitive task. We'll give the autoencoder the transformed images and ask to recover the original images. Starting with denoising, we add noise to the images, and once we present it to the autoencoder without training, we get images without noise. The autoencoder has never seen noise during training at this point, so it will not reproduce noisy images. However, the classes don't really correspond. The recovered digits, for example, here we had an 8, and it came back in the output as a 2. Now, after we train the autoencoder, we see there's some improvement. So this 8 becomes a 3, but we see that digit 5 is correctly reconstructed as a digit 5. Second task is image completion, whereas when we give the occluded images to the autoencoder, it's better than the noisy task, but still there is it improves after training. Fourth task is the rotated images. And this is how the autoencoder perceives it without training. And we see that is, this is a bit hard. But after training, we see that some digits really start improving. And if I train it longer, this will probably get even better with training. Look at this cloud of digits in the encoder map. And you'll see there's a missing digit class, which is number 6. So we try to answer the question, how would an object, an image, a digit class, how would we perceive it if we had never seen it before? And we ask this of the autoencoder, and this is the result. Of course, it will represent these unseen digits as something similar to digits it has seen before. Now the last task is perhaps a bit alien, so hold on to your hat. The autoencoders that we've been using are fully connected ANNs, artificial neural networks, and these networks, they don't take into consideration the fact that this pixel is next to the other one, because before providing the images to the autoencoder, we put them as a vector, as a line. And the autoencoder, with this fully connected ANN architecture, doesn't take into consideration adjacent values, so values of one pixel next to the other. So to prove this point, we shuffle all pixels from the MNIST dataset in the same way. So we take one random shuffle and we apply it to all digits. So this is the result of one random shuffle. So you can see that it's really not very recognizable after shuffling. And we do the same thing to the autoencoder. So we take images, we add noise, we shuffle, and we present it to the autoencoder. And then on the output, we present the shuffled pixels, but without noise. And this is the shuffled images, but without noise. So to us, they look very similar to the ones that have noise. But then when we unshuffle them, we see that the autoencoder did denoise the images, even though it doesn't use any information about adjacent pixels. That's it. It's coding time, and I hope you enjoy this tutorial.